I have been a proud student of Odissi with Guru Shradha for 8 years now. Niharika Mohanty, whom we call Rini Appa, has been my guru, and she's opened up many ways to approach the dancing body and work through it. I think of the Bharatanatyam language as something that creates poetry with the musical notes or swaras, and Odissi, on the other hand, creates its language from the space between the swaras, in which we call in Carnatic music as the gamakams. So it's very nuanced. Odissi teaches that nuance. I can proudly say that Guru Shraddha, with Rini Appa's creative vision and direction, has brought all of us closer to that idea of nuance. It won't be far from the truth when I say that Guru Shraddha is one of the very few organizations in the whole of America which maintains the rigor that this dance form, Odissi, demands. I'm not just saying this. I was fortunate to participate at the International Odissi Dance Festival that was held earlier in 2019 at Charlotte, and had the pleasure of watching so many Odissi dance groups from around the United States perform at this space. There were several amazing schools of dance, but without any bias, coming from the stand of being a teacher myself, I teach Bharatanatyam, but I teach to students, so I know the whole process of teaching. So from the process, from the point of view of a teacher, as a dancer, as a critic, a connoisseur, and a promoter of art, I can say that Guru Shraddha students and the performance they did definitely stood apart. It was a proud moment for me to call myself a student of Guru Shraddha at that space. You know, that is why I urge many of my Bharatanatyam students to learn from Rini Appa all the time. The idea of, you know, centering, the idea of stillness, the idea of finding space and time within a given, you know, musical arc, are all things that are useful in any dance form, and these are things that keeps getting reiterated in Rini Appa's teaching methodologies, that you can take that to any dance form. And I feel my Bharatanatyam has become incrementally better, you know, in my own opinion, because of this additional cross training that I'm saying that I've been taking with Guru Niharika Mohanty or Rini Appa. In addition to the absolutely invaluable training given by Rini Appa, every year the students of Guru Shraddha also get directly trained by none other than the doyens of Odissi, Sujata Mahapatra and Radhikat Mahapatra. The kind of diligence, perspective, outlook and exposure these two doyens bring to the mix is exceptional. It was a master thought that Rini Appa started Guru Shraddha with these two doyens to collaborate with her. And they are part of this only because of Appa's super sincerity towards the ideals of our much revered Paramaguru, Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra. Rini Appa also tries to get our school to participate in many mainstream dance spaces. So apart from making sure that she carries on the ideals of her guru, whom she reveres, whom she passes on that guru bhakti to all of us, as she feels it, you know, which is why the organization itself is called Guru Shraddha. She also makes sure that the ideals of the Odissi that she builds is also seen in mainstream dance spaces. So that is one of Guru Shraddha's core, core principles, core missions. For example, this year, Guru Shraddha participated in Femina in San Francisco, which is co-produced by Guru Shraddha and Sangam Arts Mosaic Silicon Valley. And then she also participated in San Francisco International Arts Festival, San Francisco Ethnic Dance Festival, International Arts Festival. And right now they're going to be participating in this thing called the Nutshell in War Memorial Theater. So all of these venues are mainstream theaters. So it is not just that Guru Shraddha showcases its work within the Indian community, which it does too, but also tries to take it to other spaces. And that's kind of one of a very inspiring thing for somebody like me, who is an artistic director of my own dance school, to take the dance form, especially because you are in a diasporic space, especially because you have access to all those spaces, to go beyond your realm and try to make the dance form available to other spaces too. That's something that as a promoter, as a teacher and an artistic director of my own small dance school, I learned and I'm still learning from Riniappa. I just have to say that thanks for being such a guiding force for many of us dancers, and just something which I've always told many of my collaborators whom I have worked in both in the dance in Odissi and other dance spaces, that if you are looking at cross training your body, if you're a Bharatanatyam dancer or a Kuchipudi dancer and want to find some of the nuance of your body that maybe your dance idiom does not give you the space to explore, you should all definitely try Odissi. And I definitely would highly recommend all of us to have that kind of exposure to Odissi through Guru Shraddha in the North American space. If you are in North America, that's a very, very good institution to be associated with for us to understand, cross-train in this other discipline, and get yourself into this organization. You'll be truly grateful for the entire experience.